So, I just skipped few lines just to I'm just trying to maximize the takeaway message from my talk. So I felt like difficulty in writing these lines because we can't summarize the genetic talk, a genetic work in few lines, but still I'm just trying. So India is genetically not a single large population. Instead, it is best described as many smaller isolated populations. Endogamy practice in India is very old and has taken place over time. And the tribal and caste groups are not systematically different. Caste grew directly out of tribal-like organization. So we don't have much genetic differences between caste and tribe. And India is a melting pot which gave rise to several world population. We did not find any RN invasion from the data which what we have in our hand. And there's a very famous quote. I'm just keeping it here. So it is product of an unscientific culturally biased form of thinking that saw race in terms of color. Scientifically speaking, there are no such things as Aryan or Dravidian races. The three primary races are Caucasian, the Mongoloid, and Negroid. Both Aryans and Dravidians are related branches of the Caucasian race. Biologically, both the North and South Indians are the same Caucasian race. Only when closer to the equator are the skin become darker. Caucasian race is not the white race. It can be of any color from pure white to almost pure black with every shadow of brown in between. This is not my statement. This I have just taken from internet, written by Thomas R. Trotman from University of Michigan, USA. So the few lines about the Dravidian and Vedic culture. The best Vedic chanting rituals are preserved in South India. Dravidians do not have to feel that Vedic culture is any more foreign to them than it is to the people of North India. They need not to feel that they are necessarily different than the people of the North. They need not feel that they are losing their culture by using Sanskrit, nor need they feel that they have to assist themselves against North India or Vedic culture to protect their real heritage. Meanwhile, the people of North India also need not take this North-South division as something fundamental. It is not racial differences that make the skin of South India darker, but merely the effect of climate and gene. The Aryans and Dravidians are part of the same culture, and we need not speak of them as separate. Dividing them and placing them at odds with each other serves the interest of neither, but only serves to damage their common culture. Perhaps the saddest thing is that modern Indian politicians have also used this division to promote their own ambitions, though it is harmful to the unity of the country. So, the last but not least, India is the cradle of the human race, the birthplace of human speech, the mother of history, the grandmother of legal legend, and the great-grandmother of tradition. Our most valuable and most instructive materials in the history of man are treasured up in India only. That was quoted by Mark Twain in 1835, who lived 1835 to 1910. So I'm very much thankful to my collaborators who are working with me, and without the help of the collaborators, it's really very hard to generate this much of data. And I'm very much thankful to Sangam Talks to provide this opportunity.